My second makeup tutorial. I'm doing the smoky eyed look. Last time I did the classic red lip look. It doesn't matter how big or how skinny you are. What matters is what's on the inside that counts. But you know, you can bring out the beauty, your natural beauty. See, I don't look all that hot right now because I have no makeup on and just whatever. So we're going to go with this. We're going to do the smoky eyed look, and later on I'll do my hair and everything, and I'll show you my outfit and everything, and showing you that thicker girls can be pretty too. 1 second. First thing I do is I always do the concealer under the eyes. Kind of dab it on. If you rub it in, it just makes the crease more dramatic. Okay, so we're gonna do that, pat it on. I tend to do the eye makeup first before the face makeup because the eye makeup can get pretty messy. So, I'm gonna take my primer, Hard Candy. Hard Candy is my favorite brand of makeup. I just put it all over my eyes and my face. Okay. Now, the smoky eye look, I'm not going for the dark smoky eyed look. Didn't really explain that at the beginning. This is for blue eyes, but it's going to be for brown eyes look. And you'll see it makes the eyes pop. Okay. So once the primer is on the eyes, I kind of let it dry. So we're just going to let it dry for a little bit. And then I get all my brushes ready and everything. Okay, so this is pretty much dried. And then I'm going to take my Maybelline Chic Naturals Vanilla. And I use a brush for everything, but for bases, I always use my finger because you're going to get and you're gonna go highlight in the inner corner of your eyes. Okay. I don't know what it is, but today I am going to my son's soccer practice and his father is going to be there. Now keep in mind that I'm married and his father and I are no longer together. He's bringing his girlfriend or slash fiance, and her and I get along really well, but for some reason whenever I'm around her I always have to make sure I look my best. Comment below if that's not an uncommon thing. Girls can be pretty catty. They want to show off to their ex, look what you had, and now you don't. No, that's really catty of me to say that, but it's a known fact. Okay, so now that we got the base on, we're going to really rub it in. I'm going to use this brush. And the very vanilla, the same vanilla I used. Always before you do your makeup, you always start with a clean face, clean palette. And you always want to clean your brushes. So, okay. Since I'm doing the base look, the beige look, I should say, my husband got me the beauty books. They come in a gift set. You get them at Walmart for really cheap. But they're really pretty colors, and I really think they'll work. So I'm going to try these out today. I'm going to go with a with my fluffy brush again, the same brush I used for the vanilla. And I'm going to use this color. That one. It's kind of like a champagne look, if you will. And I'm going to put it on the inner corner of my eye. I really like it. See, you don't have to go... I never use MAC or any of the expensive makeups, like, ever. I always go with cheap, and cheap actually, you know, it works just as well. It's all about how you apply it. And this will kind of highlight it in a corner of my eye. You know, just take your finger and just highlight in there. Okay. Next, hard candy. So, I love hard candy. See how my eyes are like really wow pop already? Okay, so, and I haven't even started with the fun stuff. Okay, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna take this brush, the angled brush, and use this color, another champagne. We're gonna go on the inner corners pop. Probably wondering, when do you get to the smoky part? Okay. Now we're gonna do the crease, and I got this special crease brush from my sister for Christmas. I love it. It's angled, so you can get right the creases there. And I always go with the darker color for the creases. I'm going to do this one for the creases. And really get in the crease, outer crease area. There, go. It really deepens your eyes. Just the crease, ladies. You don't want to go too crazy. Okay, and then to blend it together, I'm going to take my blending brush, which is this one right here. Okay, and kind of blend it in. Okay, see how that brings out my eyes. Okay, and then for my outer corners, stuff I like to use this brush, and I'm going to use an even darker color, this one right here. Tap off the excess, and you're going to go right here in the outer lids. Now we have this smoky brown eyed look. I haven't done the eyeliner yet. I'm going to highlight. So what I'm going to do is get my highlighting brush and grab my beauty book, and I'm going to highlight like a gold champagne. So this color right here. Can't really see it too well in the camera. Gives it kind of a dramatic look. You're gonna go all the way up to your brow and then in the inner crease. Then you guessed it, you're going to take your blending brush again and blend it. Blend, blend, blend. Okay, to give it more of a more dramatic look, you're going to take this brush again. And you're going to go with your darkest color. And just do the outsides, kind of dab it in. Because we're going for the smoky brown eyed look. This would look really good with brown eyes. But with blue, it looks good too. Okay. So then that. And that. Okay. Now we're going to do the eyeliner. Oh, one other thing. Is I like to make the insides of the pop. So I use NYC Eye Dust color. And, Pink topaz, NYC, okay? So you're gonna take this and you're gonna go on the inner corner of your eye and kind of go around the rim in the inner corner. It's like a dusting. Okay? Alright, so then this is my absolute favorite eyeliner. It came with mascara. It's Scandal Eyes by Rimmel. And it's kind of like a liquid liner, but a pencil. Okay, see that? I love it, love, love it. So then what you're going to do is you're going to make a cat eye. And go in. And to do the same for the other eye. I'm gonna pull it out a little bit. And then go on the inside inner corner. Just a little bit. Okay. See how it does that? And then, to finish a little bit, I'm gonna go with actual eye pencil, like a harder one. This is Wet n Wild. Let's see, you don't have to be. You wanna go in your waterline very lightly. See how it did the outer corners just really heavily? It kind of brings my eyes to a wee look, you know, like open. And since we're doing the brown smoky eye, you really kind of want to do your eyeshadow underneath your eye. So you're going to grab your smallest brush again. Excuse me. Okay. You're gonna take your hard candy palette again. I'm gonna do it in this color. Okay. If I can grab it. Okay. And you're just gonna go underneath the line. Kind of blend it together. Okay. Be careful you don't get it in your eye too much, like I just did. Okay, so now we got the full-on makeup. Yeah. On the eyes. And then you're just gonna curl your eyelashes. Huh. A lot of girls think if you curl your eyelashes after you apply your mascara, that's a good idea, but it's really, really bad for your eyes. So I always use two or three different kinds of mascaras because it really makes the eyes pop. You don't constantly always have to go in and then take another layer out of stuff. You just apply, apply, apply. Okay. Many, many coats. See, I don't use false eyelashes either. There is a way you can make your natural eyelashes appear larger, and that's by really paying attention to the outer corners of your eye. And really, the more you apply, the better, and you want to get on the other side. So just really, really apply. Can't stress that enough. Okay. Once this is done, I'll show you. It's like, it's just a lot of applying. Make sure you get your bottom lashes. It's really important. Stuff is a nightmare to take off, but it's worth it for the day. Oh, just smudged. Okay. Quick fix. Okay. To fix the smudge, just take your... Okay, so then take the other mascara. This is L'Oreal. One thing that ladies always forget is to do the eyebrows. So what you're going to do is this eye pencil. It came in that kit, that cheap kit from Walmart. You want to give it a kind of shape. And then you want to brush them in. This really contours your eyes. Okay. And this, which I barely ever use, is to brush your eyelashes through. Kind of smooth them out. Okay, now I'm going to apply another coat of mascara. And this is, again, Scandalized. This is the Curve Alert. This is the regular. Okay. So, really, really makes them pop. Okay. And then more on the bottom. See, you don't need false eyelashes. You can really play up your regular eyelashes. If you go really heavy in the corners, again, it really pulls out your eyelashes. See? Thick eyelashes. Okay, now I'm going to do the face. Since I already used concealer, I'm going to apply my foundation. And this is Revlon Photo Ready in the Golden Beige. Okay. Make sure your hands are nice and clean before you apply foundation if you're going to be using your hands. Ladies, one squirt goes a long way. If you have to use two, but you don't want it caked on. Okay. One thing to make it look nice and airbrushed is to use a blush brush or a foundation brush. Any kind of big blush brush can be turned into a foundation brush. You don't need to spend the extra dollars for actual foundation brush. They are expensive. Save your money where you can. Cheap makeup adds up too, trust me. And if you use it every day, it's gonna go by fast. Okay. Okay. So, just because it's winter doesn't mean you can't look like you have a tan. You don't have to look like you don't have a tan. So, I use my NYC Sun and Bronzer. It's almost gone. I'm sad. Use this brush, big fluffy expert powder brush, if you will. Dab it in. Oh! Just lost them down the drain. Fail. Okay, so I'm gonna really apply it all over the face, under the eyes. And I just threw some down the drain. That's lovely. Okay. Make sure you get your neck area. You really want that blended in. You don't want that masked look. Near your ears and near your hairline and everything. Okay, I don't like to use blush. It gives you that pink doll rosy look. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna dab in your bronzer. And go on your cheeks. Okay. Now that we got the face done, we're gonna do the lips. Okay. Since I'm going dramatic with the eyes, I don't want to go dramatic with the lips too, because that will make it look. Look at me! Wow, look at me! You know. So really, I kind of want to use a light color. Again, you don't have to go super expensive. I know this is kind of a 90s look, but you can blend it in to make it look natural. So really blend it in. It's gonna make your lips stick, stay on better. And then I use this pink so it's not as pink. Okay, then I'm gonna use a gloss. Pink looks good with the brown. Okay, so then you're gonna take this flat eyeshadow brush. And you're going to take the vanilla, again, by Maybelline. And just dab on the crown of your lips. Or use your finger, one of the two. There you have it. The brown look. Okay, I'll show you my hair in a minute. Bye. So you have your makeup done and you want to do your hair and everything and you don't know what to do with this wild, crazy hair. I'll show you my husband's favorite look on me. It's very simple. Anybody with medium length hair can do it. Okay. I have crazy hair. It needs to be touched up drastically. You see the roots. One thing I always like to do is the bump look. So you can take it, twist it. But I'm gonna make it more sophisticated. Watch and learn. Just gonna brush it down. See how that looks? But the hair is not like, you can simply take it and pull it back. I don't know why, but my husband loves this look. It's very sophisticated looking. Anyway, then you're gonna spray it. Or as I say, shellac it. There you have it, the hair and makeup. Really bad lighting, I apologize. But see, my outfit? It's all wrong. So I'll show you what it will look like in a minute. Okay? Here you can see the makeup in natural daylight. Very natural. See that?